Ann Coulter, of course, one of the best-selling authors in the country. Her latest book, Resistance is Futile, and a great columnist. You should just go to anncoulter.com. Make sure you follow Ann Coulter on Twitter. You can get the latest column and all the stuff there. And get her books, anncoulter.com or Amazon. Ann Coulter, how you doing? Would you agree last night was the worst moderated debate ever in history?
Are you kidding? I thought it was fantastic. It was hilarious. Oh, I loved it. That was my favorite debate so far.
All right, that's true. But that Gayle King didn't seem to know what was going on. You know, like the
they looked like children. It was hilarious. I loved the way they're like raising their hands, like they're the bratty little sixth grader. Oh, me teacher, please call on me. And then just the constant free-for-alls. You know, some people are making fun of Biden, but I actually thought he made a good point toward the end of the debate because they had, you know, time limits and there are lights there. And so he gets to his, whatever it was, 45 seconds, 60 seconds, and, you know, just sort of stops abruptly. And then he says, why am I stopping? Nobody else stopped.
Yeah, that's true. I'm reading the analyst in the New York Times. One says Bloomberg improved. It was a much slower train wreck this time.
Bloomberg would probably be the worst of all possible candidates. Because I think he would stand a better chance of beating Trump, which isn't saying a whole lot. But also, what terrifies me about Bloomberg is he'd actually get stuff done. I tweeted this out yesterday. The more I watch Bernie and hear about Bernie, I think really not that much of a threat. You know, his cabinet is all going to be smoking pot. Hillary talks about, and I think this is true, I've heard this elsewhere, that nobody likes him in the Senate. He just goes, he is like the left-wing Trump. He goes around shooting his mouth off, but never actually accomplishes anything.
Now, Trump gets some things done. But one thing about Bloomberg, if you look back at that mayoral record, it was pretty choppy. There were a lot of screw-ups when he was mayor.
Oh, I think they were all screw-ups, but good gosh, he got it all done.
Well, not all of it. Remember, he was going to turn around the schools. He never got anything done there.
You mean something good. No, I mean the crazy authoritarian stuff, taking salt off the tables, those heinous bike lanes, the no smoking any place where Bloomberg's, you know, fascist smoking police could come after you. No, he gets it done. Say a little bit the same thing with Warren. She's really got to settle down. She's now, you know, pushing me. I've always taken the position that the 19th Amendment giving women the vote was a rash experiment that needs to be reconsidered. But I've clarified, because people would always say, oh, but you write books. No, I didn't say women can't write books or have jobs. I definitely think women should be armed. They can run for office. Well, I'm reconsidering they can run for office after watching Warren. Man, she's a pain in the neck. I mean, she really was in large part responsible for what a disaster that debate was, because she won't shut up.
Now, a lot of people, like James Carville, others are saying, obviously she's more concerned about destroying Bloomberg than winning, that it's more important, for whatever reason, she's just trying to take out Bloomberg instead of campaigning for herself.
Well, she's not doing a very good job, except among, you know, which I guess is what matters, the insane Democratic base, pedal to the metal on all this crazy feminist crap. But who knows? Understand these Democrats, but my sense of it is, remember about three or four debates back, she did go after Bloomberg, and the Bernie bros ganged up on her and attacked her, so I think she realized, treat Bernie with kid gloves. I want people to realize I'm the Bernie who will get stuff done. And so she's got to go after somebody.
Yeah. Now, Biden, and this is how rigged these debates are. Remember the first few debates, they never mentioned Hunter Biden. So in this debate, shouldn't they have brought up that Biden made up a whole fake story about getting arrested in South Africa? Shouldn't the moderator have said to him, what the hell were you talking about?
I did see a very good suggestion that the debate moderators, that it just, you know, be done like by computer and let Twitter users send in their questions. And I promise you it would have been more hard-hitting and interesting. But, I mean, I guess in the case of Democrats, this is both good and bad for Democrats. They know that in the final debate with Donald Trump, it's going to be the same moderators, and they're still not going to ask the Democrats any difficult questions. I mean, even Chris Wallace in the Trump-Hillary debates, it still makes me sit back sort of stunned, considering what happened subsequently. And that is, Wallace only asked Trump, will you accept the results of the election?
Yeah.
I mean, even at the time I was tweeting, can we ask Hillary that?
Yeah. And she's the one that didn't accept it.
Right! And we've been living with the Democrats, spearheaded by Hillary, not accepting the results of the election ever since.
And
no, that question doesn't, I mean, to plant that in people's minds, as I've often said, this is some of the most penetrating propaganda isn't when a news anchor or debate moderator comes out and tells you something like, Donald Trump is a racist. A normal TV viewer would think, well, you know, come on, wait a second, give me some evidence. No, the way they plant the suggestion is by saying, will you denounce David Duke? And then the viewer thinks, well, there must be some reason to ask that. They think they're, you know, being smart there, and that's when the propaganda penetrates. And it's the same thing with Chris Wallace asking Trump, but not Hillary, are you willing to accept the results of the election?
Yeah.
It just subconsciously your brain tells you, ooh, he must be a scary authoritarian. So on one hand, it does help them in the end that the debate moderators for the national debates are going to be the same left-wing loons protecting their precious little Democrats. But the bad thing about that is their candidates are never vetted properly because they aren't asked difficult questions at this point in the campaign.
You know, even Buttigieg got a little nervy last night. He actually said, you know, last time I was in South Carolina was when I trained for combat. Where was the moderator said, you never trained for combat?
Well, the Twitter users pointed that one out.
You were never in combat. You had a minor desk job at a base. You never even went to boot camp.
Yes. Oh, he loves bragging about his service. And no, it comes down to the Twitter users to point out the truth.
Yeah. Well, Ann Coulter, new column comes out tonight. Can you give us a hint what it'll be about?
Yes, it was a huge story this week that the media has not reported on because they're too busy with their indistinguishable hysteria from every other night about some bland, unimportant thing Trump did, which they believe will rock the foundations of our nation.
All right. Well, that comes out tonight. Make sure you follow Ann Coulter on Twitter. Some of the best stuff is on Twitter there. Ann Coulter on Twitter, AnnCoulter.com. Follow her on Instagram, all that stuff. And get her book. If you're a Democrat, get this book, Resistance is Futile. It'll explain to you what you're doing wrong. Get any of Ann Coulter's books. And Ann Coulter, thanks for being with us.
Thank you. Good to talk to you, Mark Simone.
All right, take care.